Hi, I'm Anton, and I'm going to walk you through Virtual Photography Kit for Unreal. It's a set of blueprints and lighting presets that I use all the time for creating product shots or portrait photos. It's great for professionals who need a smoother workflow, but also for complete beginners who want to get started in Unreal. Unreal can be used for many different purposes, and it can be a bit overwhelming in the beginning. So these tools are made to make your life easier. I've exposed only the parameters needed for high quality lighting, and all other settings are already set to their optimal values. These tools work both with ray tracing and without, but I strongly recommend using these with a ray tracing capable card, since the results you'll get will look so much better. In this video, I'll get you a quick overview of all the features, and if you need in-depth videos of each specific feature, you can find those in the documents or the playlist in the description. So let's get started. So when you bought Virtual Photography Kit in the marketplace, you'll find it in the Games Launcher in the Unreal Engine tab under Library. And you just press Create Project. And then it will appear under your projects. And you just double click it to start it. So this is the first thing you'll see when you get into the project. First of all, I recommend using this project instead of migrating this pack into your own project, because in this virtual photography project, I've already set the project settings to their optimal settings. So that way you don't have to care about setting all that yourself. So first of all, we want to set some settings in the editor to make sure that what we're seeing is as close to the final render that we're going to render out. So first of all, you want to set cinematic viewport. This is so that when you look through the camera, you will always see the correct aspect ratio, which you won't see in the default viewport. So this is what I mean. And if I change it, it updates correctly. And this is what it will look like when rendering as well. The other settings I want to change is to make sure that the scalability settings are set to cinematic. So what we see in the viewport is going to be the maximum quality. So let's make a test render. So what you want to do is go into the Virtual Photography Kit folder and then right click the render widget and run editor utility widget. So it will pop out like this the first time, but I would recommend docking it to a place like this, for example. So everything here is already set up, so you can basically just press render now and we'll see the results. And when that's finished, we can just press open folder and we'll find our image here. So this is using the default settings, which are already set to pretty high, just because we don't want to have to dabble around in all of the post-processing settings just to find the right settings. So that's why I've set it up for you like this. So let's go through these buttons here. So first of all, the viewport buttons, default is default, of course. If you want to get closer to the final render quality directly in the viewport, you can press high. It's going to start lag a bit, but you will see a much higher quality representation of the scene. And if you find it's too laggy, even on default, you can go to low even, and that will make the performance a bit smoother. So let's go back to default. So on the resolution settings here, you can choose between different preset resolutions. These are actually connected to the camera blueprint. So when you change the film back here, you can see that it's actually changing the resolution to the correct aspect ratio, like this. And if you don't want it to do that, then you can just lock the ratio and you can have whatever resolution that you want. On the screenshot here, you can do some quick screenshots if you don't want to render all the time. So just press screenshot, press open folder and you'll see your screenshot. And this is from the viewport and not the actual render camera. Here's all the render settings. So in order to render something, you always need a sequence. So if you double click this, you get it open in the sequencer here. And the basics that you need is a camera and a camera cuts track. And this is already set up for you in this tutorial level and also in the preset levels that you find here for these different purposes. And then we got the render preset where you can choose what kind of output you want. And we did a still image here and we have the file name and some other settings here. And here's the render settings. So the difference between screenshot and render is that the render is a much higher quality image output. So the screenshot you can use for quick previews, but you always want to go do a render, a proper render for your final output. You can also export this to the movie render queue if you feel comfortable with changing those settings yourself, because there's tons of different settings that you can use here, and you can always go in and override these and render it from the render queue instead. So when you've done your changes here, you press render local here instead of this render button here. And then finally you have the documentation here, which brings up the documentation page in a web browser. So let's say we want to render a video of this instead. So in this actual sequence, we actually have an animation as well. But by default, it's only set to render one frame. What we can do is check use custom frame range and then put 150 here, which is the end frame here. And then if we choose video and just press render. And when that's finished, we can just press open folder and have a look at the video. And there it is. So let's take a look at the portrait lighting and how to bring in some characters from MetaHuman Creator. So when you've done MetaHuman in MetaHuman Creator, it will appear in your Quixel bridge under My MetaHumans. So you choose the MetaHuman you want and just press export. And that will bring your MetaHuman into the MetaHumans folder. So let's go to the portrait level because it's already set up for portrait lighting with a backdrop and the focus and camera set at head level. So let's just drag and drop our character into the scene like this. We can zero out the translations. We can click the camera and you can either right click and then pilot camera, or you can press Control Shift P to do the same thing. So here you can press G to get rid of these visualizations. So what we can do here now is go through all the different lighting presets if you want. Take a look at a few of them. And when we find some preset that we like, then we'll have to make sure of one thing, and that is setting the change streaming method to always loaded. That way it will know what level it should load. And then make sure that all the other levels have blue dots, because that means that they're not going to be rendered. So the eye icon here is only for the editor, and this is not respected in the render. So with that done, we choose the portrait sequence. So this is the sequence that's also found here. And it's just set up with a camera and a camera track, so you don't have to do it every time. We'll choose still image here, and we'll just render one frame and press render. And when that's done, open folder, choose the portrait folder, and there you have your portrait photo. Okay, so what if you want to make your own scene from scratch? And I'll show you how to do it. So let's create a new level. Just call it test for now. Load it up. You can just save selected here. And it's of course empty. So what we're going to start with is having a backdrop. Zero way out, and we'll add the core blueprint. So the core blueprint contains a lot of settings that are set to high quality settings by default, and it also exposes all of these post-process settings and ray tracing settings that you want to tweak in your scene. Let's add a camera and a light. And then we of course want to have a character. Zero out. And I like to have two viewports working with the lights and having the camera set to the biggest viewport. So what I mean is choosing the camera, Control Shift P to jump into that. Let's position it as we want it. Something like that. And then in the second viewport, you can choose the light. Also do the same thing. So we Control Shift P to pilot that one, and now we can see it from the light's perspective. So let's just put it somewhere here, and as you can see, the focus is not correct. So that's what we use the focus point for. Just drag it up into the scene, and in the second viewport, oh, make sure to eject from the light so you don't accidentally move the light, and then set the focus point. What you have to do as well is in the camera, you have to choose the focus point. So now it's always focusing on that focus point. So now when we move it, it's set correctly. So we'll just set it on her, let's tweak this, set it on her eye. And you could actually use any actor for this. I just like to use this one because it has this nice visualization, so it's easier to set it like that. And now if we move the camera around in here, you can see that the focus is always set to that eye, no matter where you move the camera. So that's pretty nice. Let's put the camera here somewhere. And let's take a look at the light. You can change the intensity and the temperature and a bunch of other settings. So I'm gonna have an in-depth video for each of these blueprints where I go through all of the settings. But for now, we'll just go with this. So there is one more thing we need to do before we render, and that's adding a level sequence. So let's just create one here and drag and drop the camera into here, and then also create a camera cut track. And then press the camera and choose your camera. So now we have, if we look through the camera here, you can see this is the camera that we created before. And these steps you don't have to do if you use one of the presets, which will save you time, like the portrait, product, or automotive presets, because this is already set up there. So in order to render, we have to remember to choose the new sequence that we created. So this is the one getting rendered. And before I press render, I just want to show you the last blueprint, which is the burn-in blueprint. So drag and drop that into your scene. And what this does is it adds some text to your image. So if you're sending over images to your client, maybe you want to have a version number. Maybe you want to have an author name. And let's put in the date as well. You can change the font size, you can change the color, and so on. Let's add a little bit of a background as well. Press OK. And now we just press render and see what it looks like. So press open folder, and it's now in the folder named after our sequence that we created. And open it up. And now you can see the burn-in with the author, date, and the version number. So this is just one of the styles. If you want a more minimal style of burn-in, you can choose it here. We have a minimal, and you can change the font size and then press render again, and we'll see how that one looks like. And here it is. So that was the overview of all of the blueprints and what you can do with this virtual photography kit. And in the documents, you can find more videos and documentation on what all of these different blueprints do. And thanks for watching.